from the IFL TV in association with MTK Global. I'm at the Barclaycard Arena in Birmingham, and with me, I've got the WBC International Super Bantamweight.
Super Bantamweight.
Castle holder with me, Sean Davis. Just announced, well, it was announced before, and obviously this is the
time has come. Yeah,
first press conference for you fighting Gamal Yafire. A tough fight. He is one of Birmingham's golden boys, and you're one of the other guys.
But,
you've come to do a job.
Yeah, you know, I was supposed to fight him last time. There was a big show in Birmingham, which is a show I won the WBC International title on. Good show, but this show is obviously a lot better. You've got Cali's older brother, who's just won a world title. The rise of Sam Eggington, Frankie Gavin's on the comeback. You couldn't ask for a better card for Birmingham boxing, to be honest. And I'm just, you know, I'm mega, mega excited for the opportunity that Matchroom's given me.
Obviously, you said that he's hungry, but you're starving.
That's it.
I mean, he was given a podium to come up on, sort of thing. He was GB and levels like that. Where you've come from? Just amateur background?
Nothing. Hardly any amateur background. I had a half and half record when I was an amateur, which is obviously not the best. I had, I think, 23 fights with 13 wins, which is nothing. He has got a podium to come up on, but no doubt about it, he deserved it. So obviously he worked hard when he was an amateur. I didn't, that was the difference. But now I'm 100% dedicated. I'm on a totally different planet compared to what I was as an amateur. And any of the amateurs that I lost to, if I went back and fought them, I'd beat them.
Are you boxing full time at the moment?
No, I work as well. So I'm a fabricator as well during the day.
So you ain't got it easy?
No, it's never been easy. Nothing's ever been easy for me. Like I says, these guys are hungry fighters. I'm a starving fighter, and that's going to be the difference on the night.
What do you think? Obviously, you've sparred both of the brothers, so you know what they're about. What do you think you bring to the table that could put you above him and beat him?
I think he's underrating my skill set a little bit. You know, I know Gamal's a puncher. He's very strong. He likes to come forward. But the harder people try, the better I look. If someone comes and gives 100%, you're going to automatically get an extra 10% out of me without me even trying.
I like that. 12-0. I think the knockout ratio is what people look upon, and they think, well, he's not much of a puncher. He can't do this, he can't do that. But have you got it in your locker to bang?
Currently at the moment, I scored a knockdown in my last fight. And I fought one more round and I'd have had him out of there. And I thought at the end of the fight, I wasn't really tired, which was a bit disappointing for myself. I want to make myself tired during the fights, and you know, I could have done, I had a six round out, I could have done another 12 on top of that and not batting an eyelid at that pace. And it was a very high paced fight. My power's going up and up. And I think in this camp, you know, I've got my strength and conditioning coach with me full time now. And he's just putting it through the roof, you know.
Well, I'm excited for this fight.
Yeah.
I like it. It's going to be a good fight.
It's going to be a good fight. I've got mega respect for Gamal, mega respect for his brother. They've done a lot in boxing. Gamal's obviously Commonwealth champion. I'm the WBC champion, but it's going to stay that way.
All right, well, listen, Sean, obviously best of luck training and fabricating, and hopefully one day you're not starving and you're at the top.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah. You know, I want to be at the top, but when I get to the top, I'm going to be even more hungry. You know, I don't take nothing for granted.
That's the way you got to be. But obviously, I'm sure I'll catch up with you before the fight, because I'm sure there'll be a few more press conferences and a weigh-in and stuff.
Yeah,
but,
of course, yeah.
Until then, I'll catch up with you next time. But
appreciate
Sean,
it,
thanks for
Thank
IFL
you.
TV.
Thank you,
top man.